It's me.
Another brutal week in Gotham, folks. A string of home invasions rippled through the city's already crime-infested East End. Apparently, the bandits are using stolen GCPD battery rams to force their way in, with breaking and entering incidents up 40% over last year. Remember to keep those front doors locked tonight. And we have breaking news tonight. Five criminals are in custody this evening after a break-in at City Hall. The notorious Batman was on the scene, but failed to secure the stolen items.
Not all of them. Let's see what she was really after.
Allegations that Dent may have actually been involved in the break-in. Talk about dirty politics. Does Hill's campaign really think these accusations hold any water with the voters? Or will it be perceived as a desperate attempt from a flailing campaign to take down one of Gotham's most promising young politicians?
And in other news, we are now on day 3 of the factory fire that will not end. Crews have given up trying to combat the blaze at the Otisburg Processing Center, owned by Ace Chemical. Still no word on what started the fire, but whatever's burning in there has resisted everything the fire department has thrown at it. They're recommending people avoid the area and seek immediate treatment if you happen to breathe in any of that tar black smoke.
And one mobster's murder caused quite a headache for commuters this morning. The body of
I don't like Vicky, and I can't stand Falcone. I don't know his first name. Carmine? Falcone? I can't stand them.
Random stabbings are the latest headache for the riders of Gotham's overcrowded Skyrail cars to contend with. Gotham police are investigating multiple cases of riders receiving abdominal wounds from an ice pick or other pointed weapon while pressed into the tight quarters with fellow passengers. A few have died, while most have been admitted to Gotham General in critical condition. The police don't have any suspects at the time. Two more patients have gone missing from Arkham Asylum, bringing the total number of escapees from the half-prison, half-mental hospital to 15 this year. Only 3 have been caught to date, but all the escapees highlight the rough.
Nearly fell off a building for this? Let's find out what was so important.
Gotham City's biggest property owners' greater ability to mop.
Encrypted.
Wayne Manor has 7 bedrooms, 2 kitchens, a library, a gymnasium, a basketball court, and a movie theater. And yet I always find you here. In a dark, damp cave.
I'll leave as soon as I finish. People with regular jobs can do their work anywhere, but for me, this is my office.
I agree. It isn't normal work. Even worse, the best outcome is that no one ever finds out you've done it.
Yeah, well, good deeds usually go unnoticed.
Though not unappreciated. Did you find out what that, Catwoman tried to steal?
Well, in the process.
What are we looking at?
Let me try a different angle. This is a map of the East Side shoreline. But it could mean any number of things. Money, weapons, drugs, everything flows through that port.
Maybe it's where Mayor Hill picks up his dry cleaning.
Can't make sense of it yet. There's still plenty of files to decrypt.
And in the meantime, I saved you what I could.
Thanks, Al.
Yeah, the same couldn't be said for the bar. I had to literally pry Mrs. Zeller back away. But you'll be pleased to hear everyone has left, including Mr. Falcone. Before the game switched from billiards to cutthroat, I'd recommend leaving the fistfights to your alter ego. Bloodstains are much harder to remove from a tuxedo.
I don't want anything to do with Falcone.
Well, he certainly showed interest in you. That's what worries me. For the record, your father despised men like Falcone, thought they ruined Gotham's stellar reputation.
Back when it still had one?
It can again, Bruce. Though people like this Catwoman aren't helping. Is she new to town?
I've never seen her before. Hopefully, she's just a tourist. Oh, no, I already checked the Codex.
Not much to find, apparently.
A few burglaries, break-ins. Seems to lay pretty low.
You could learn a thing or two from her. You can't step outside without it ending up in the news lately. As Bruce or Batman.
I don't like being compared to a common criminal.
Now, I think you're missing the point. You have to admit you've been drawing a lot of attention to yourself, and not the playboy billionaire buys new yacht kind of attention. I don't mean to beat a dead argument, but...
No one's gonna figure it out now. Trust me.
Miss Vale noticed your injuries, so did Mr. Dent. If they put it together with the incident at the mayor's office, it would undo all the long nights and close calls we've endured to get here. You're in the spotlight more than ever. You have to be careful.
You're right. I should have canceled the event.
I know how much pressure you're under. I don't mean to add to it.
It's okay. I know you're only looking out for me.
If we make a suit that fits me, we can trade places some night. Though I'm not partial to heights. Old men worry, that's all. It's our gift and our curse. One more worry for the list.
I thought I saw Oz. It's been, what, 20 years? Last time I saw him, we were in grade school.
Indeed. You two were thick as thieves. Oswald, however, took that role more literally than you.
Dishonorable discharge, illegal boxing matches, arms dealing, prison stints?
That's a criminal grand slam, if I'm using the expression correctly.
Unfortunately, you are.
Oswald claimed he only wanted to catch up, but his behavior following his family's collapse is troubling. Why he's returning now, I haven't the faintest idea.
You think he's looking for a handout?
He would have come to the right person.
No, because I'm...
Because you're generous. A little too much sometimes, with your wealth, your time, and even your well-being. Even though you and young Master Cobblepot used to be close, I'd advise you to be cautious. But I know you can't abandon a good mystery until it's solved.
I'll be careful, Alfred.
When you see what's become of his park, I think you will.
I'm tired, y'all. If y'all can't tell, I'm gonna try and see if Juice will go get Starbucks. Ninja out here sleepy. I'm not gonna make it through the rest of this.
Where are you, Oz?
If I don't get caffeine. Alright, y'all hold up 2 seconds. I'm gonna text Wifey and Juice. See if either one of them will get me Starbucks. That's gonna be the game within the game. Trying to figure out how to get one of them to get me Starbucks. Wifey just got back from being out and helping the kids with, or taking the girls to get their hair done.
Thank you, sir.
Juice ain't doing nothing.
statue, but no Oz.
Yes, they both want it. You said yeah, wifey said yes, please. She said, wait, where are you? I'm in my room. Hey.
Beat it.
No, talk to me. Falling asleep, trying to record Batman. You Batman, but you can't walk up steps? That's what you mean to tell me?
Watch wallet cash. But this goes through you.
Boy.
Hey, you heard it, man. The hell are you waiting for?
You're making a mistake.
You already made one coming here. The next one kills you.
End him.
Gentlemen.
Oz.
Keep walking, all right?
This don't concern you, twerp.
You see, that's where you're mistaken. My old mate and I have some catching up to do. And you're ruining the moment! Come here. Think that'll do?
I'm gonna piece him up.
Stay down.
Oh. Oh, this escalated. Here's what I don't get about this game.
There's been a nice place. No lives like you don't belong. This is my park! Mine! You hear that? Oh, hey Bruce. You've got a little good as new. Woo! That was the right little scrap, eh? Nothing kickstarts the system like a dash of adrenaline, eh?
Well, thanks for the backup.
I yanked you away from your bloody ivory tower, Bruce. Least I can do is make sure you don't get shanked.
Oh, that's very thoughtful of you.
Yeah, it's been what? 2 decades?
And you know what? I haven't been mugged once that entire time.
That wasn't why I brought you here, mate. Right now, I am trying to recognize the little Bruce I used to run around this place with. Back when it wasn't, you know, like this. This park used to mean something. A place that was safe for kids, for families. People came from all over to visit. Oh, Mom and Dad, they put so much work in here.
Well, those were better days.
That they were, yeah. Thought we'd grow up to be kings, I did. Both of us. This city chews right through people. Mum committed to Arkham. Dad ended it yourself, he did. My family's fortune. There's nothing left, Bruce.
I know. Alfred told me.
It's funny, huh? Same place that ground my family to dust. Gave you the good life. Used to run in the same circles we did. Hobnobbing parties, round the world vacations, unlimited potential.
I'm sorry, Oz. No one should have to go through that.
Thanks, Bruce. But we are not the only ones suffering. Good to know you haven't changed, Bruce. You still care about something more than just yourself. Although, I was surprised to see Carmine Falcone at your party last night. Made himself right at home. That oily... Oh, wish I could have punched that grin into the back of his throat.
Falcone was an uninvited guest. That's it. I never want to see his face again.
On that, we can agree in earnest. Falcone made a stack of cash and corpses a mile high, ruining families like mine. All he needs is a little push. And it'd be a treat to watch him hit pavement. Sorry, mate. This reunion got a lot more grim than I planned. Things are gonna be on the upswing soon, no? A revolution is knocking on Gotham's door. And I'm here to let it in. Which brings me to you, Bruce. You see, you throw a rock in any direction, you break a window that Wayne Enterprises owns. As the rich and powerful go, oh, you top Gotham's list. But when my revolution starts, we're gonna smash windows and cross off names all the way down. Like I said, it's not gonna be pretty. It's gonna be beautiful.
I'm not your enemy, Oz.
That remains to be seen, don't it? I've got great affection for you, Bruce. I really do. Which is why I'm warning you. When this whole thing starts, make sure you're on the right side. Good seeing you, Bruce, but I got some rocks to collect. Cheers.
I got some rocks to collect. I don't like anyone in this game. They're either threatening me or trying to, like, debo me. Like, there's no one cool in this game. Except for me and Alfred. That's it. That's it. Or maybe I'm just ornery because I don't have coffee. I don't know.
Mr. Wayne, over here. Right here.
This way.
Bruce, Bruce!
Morning, Mr. Dent.
Hey, Bruce, you mind if we swap cars? I mean, mine isn't fast and the paint's rusting off, but boy, does she have charm. We didn't bring you all out here to discuss cars, honestly. Now, we're here about Arkham Asylum. Ever since it opened its doors, Arkham has been a breeding ground for the criminally insane. Its methods for rehabilitation, crude. Its security, lacking. Worse still, those who do get out, or God forbid, escape, are even more dangerous than before they went in. Arkham Asylum is a cancer on Gotham. But today, with a sizable contribution from this man here, we break ground on a state-of-the-art mental health care facility. One that will improve the well-being of Gotham and its citizens for years to come. Now, Mr. Wayne has a few words he'd like to say. Bruce?
For those with mental health issues, there are no cuts or scrapes. Their ailments are often invisible, but inside, they're suffering. You know, when I was 9 years old, my parents took me to see a movie about a hero in a mask. It was a hero who stood up to oppression and defended the people from injustice, no matter the cost. That night, my parents paid the ultimate cost defending me from a man who needed the kind of help this new facility will provide. With this facility and our next mayor, we create a new face for Gotham.
Today, on the anniversary of that fateful night, we dedicate this facility to Thomas and Martha Wayne and usher in a new era of healing for Gotham.
I'm sure you all have plenty of questions about the new hospital, so let's open it up. You first, Miss Vale.
Thank you. With the opening of this new hospital, what does this mean for Arkham Asylum? What happens to the old building?
We should tear down the walls and erase it from the map. I don't want us lingering on past mistakes. I want us to focus on Gotham's future. All right, who's up next? You there.
Mr. Wayne, Julia Remarque of the Tribune. My sources say you welcomed alleged mob boss Carmine Falcone into your home. You and Mr. Dent even spoke with him behind closed doors.
I don't
He's no
make
friend.
Friends with gangsters. He was an unwelcome guest. That's all. Next question, please.
I hope that
Wait,
doesn't bite
me. Questions on topic, people.
In the future.
We're here about the hospital, remember?
But Mr. Wayne, this morning the Globe received evidence of an offshore bank account managed by Carmine Falcone and your father, Thomas Wayne.
What exactly are you implying?
Transactions connected to organized crime, going back years, and continuing to this day. The paper trail ties your family directly to the mob. Care to comment?
And did anyone else receive this evidence?
The Globe, the Gazette, we all did. Mr. Wayne, Mr. Wayne, is all your money dirty?
Is the Wayne family legacy built on lies?
Did you know about this, Bruce?
How long has your family been dealing with Falcone?
Could the allegations be true?
What aren't you telling us?
Does the mob sign Wayne Enterprises paychecks?
I think you should check your source. Sounds to me like an intern is finally putting their creative writing minor to good use.
Mr. Wayne, Mr. Wayne!
How long has your family been dealing with Falcone?
Could the allegations be true?
Did you know about this, Bruce?
What aren't you telling us?
I'm sorry about this, Bruce. I don't know where the hell it's coming from. Damage control's my territory. We'll talk later.
Everyone, please, settle down. I'll be fielding your questions from here on out. Please, let's try to keep this civilized.
Bruce, I've been trying to reach you. The police are inside the manor.
Uh-oh. Crap. You think it's Falcone? Leak some stuff.
Hey, careful! Put it back.
I'm afraid we can't, Mr. Wayne.
Says who?
This warrant. It's not personal. I had the boys turn the lights off, keep a low profile.
I'm sorry, are you arresting me?
Not unless I'm forced to. We're only collecting evidence today.
I didn't do anything.
That's what we're here to find out.
Alfred, keep an eye on them. Make sure they only take what they have to.
Of course, sir.
I meant what I said about not personal. We only want files related to Wayne Enterprises. The warrant covers your place, pardon me, places of residence, and any companies you own. Your holdings are extensive.
And what do you expect to find?
That's for our analysts back at the precinct to figure out. I can't comment. It's a valid warrant. I gotta serve it. Mayor Hill signed off on this himself. As long as he's mayor, he calls the shots.
Well, Hill has a history of making his opposition disappear.
Rumors and allegations, Mr. Wayne, that's all. But if they become fact, I'll handcuff him myself, same as any other crook. I don't know how your neck ended up on Mayor Hill's shopping block, but here we are.
Hill knows if I go down, Harvey's campaign goes down too.
That'd be a real shame. Mr. Dent's the only DA I ever trusted to make a conviction stick. As mayor, I think he can finally turn things around for us. For all our sakes, I pray you've got nothing to hide.
Thank you.
Bruce, stay back!
Take whatever you want!
You don't have to do this!
I didn't mean to interrupt, but...
You're so nosy.
This is the second time you've shown up uninvited.
Well, it's difficult to book a meeting with you.
Well, I enjoy my privacy.
Enjoyed. Past tense. Sorry, but if the press has their way, you're not gonna have any for a while. Listen, Bruce. A scandal surrounding a beloved family like yours captures the public's attention. I can help you get the right kind of attention.
Oh.
Through my connections at the Gazette, I have all kinds of access. I can dig up whatever you need to fight this.
Oh.
What's your angle?
Okay.
Not all reporters just want a headline. Some of us are old-fashioned. I still want the truth. The Gazette received this supposed evidence like every other media outlet, and it's all hearsay, flimsy sources. There isn't a shred of hard proof.
Still, allegations like this, they don't magically appear. Someone is going after my family, after me.
Obviously, the sender didn't identify themselves. We have no idea who it could be. I mean, no one's even done their due diligence on this yet. The press saw the fumble, they grabbed the ball and ran.
Carmine Falcone wants me to be in his pocket. He crashed Harvey's fundraiser and pretty much said, hop in.
Well, maybe he thinks putting a little fear in you will make you jump.
It won't.
By tonight, this scandal will be broadcast to every screen in Gotham. Everyone will be talking about it.
This isn't my first pass through the rumor mill. I know the damage it can do.
Then go on the record. Right here, right now, and stop it. You need to get out ahead of this. Your side is what matters, not wild speculation.
On the record, then.
Whenever you're ready.
This story about my family is exactly that. A story. It's a work of fiction all the way through.
That's exactly what the people of Gotham need to hear. You're gonna beat this, Bruce. The Waynes always come out on top.
Goodbye, Miss Vale.
Yeah, she wanna be my girlfriend. She know what time it is.
I hate to admit it, but everyone smells smoke. A fire is heading this way.
Batman has made plenty of enemies, but my family... We've done nothing but support Gotham, even in its darkest days.
All this... On the anniversary of your parents?
It's not a coincidence. Harvey's the district attorney. He should have told me this was coming.
Then find out why he didn't.
Can't trust Harvey either, man. See, man? Can't trust these ninjas.